link for a quiz.
Says the phone is currently not accepting responses.
more minutes, I'm up to 10 responses. I'm just waiting on 5 more. blood storage. If you've ever had a scalp laceration, you get hit in the head and start bleeding. It bleeds. We do store blood in our integumentary system. Protecting the body from the external environment, you guys know that one is a given. Detecting cutaneous sensations, you guys know that one too. Obviously, cutaneous is skin. We're touching ourselves, we can feel it. Anchors and support skeletal muscle. That one is absolutely there. The skin is definitely covering everything, but it does not anchor the skin. Excreting and absorption, you guys know that. And then synthesis of vitamin D, that's a little bit abstract, but yes, absolutely. So all answers except D and F. That's nothing to do with metabolism. Has nothing to do with supporting or anchoring ourselves. Alright, so the skin is also known as the cutaneous membrane, consisting of two main parts. The thinner portion, we know that as the blank, and the deeper, thicker, connected tissue portion is known as the blank. What did you guys get for this one? Feel free to answer. B, epidermis and dermis. So, the reason why I put this question the way that I did is superficial thinner portion is known as the epidermis, the thicker, connected tissue portion is known as the dermis. When you guys start the integumentary system, they show you a diagram, and they say that that's your dermis. And then when you look at the layers, it's broken up into epidermis and dermis, so that gets confusing. So that big square chunk that they show you, and they say that's your dermis, and then it has an epidermis and then the dermis underneath it. I got confused about that when I was studying this at the beginning. That's why I did this. So that subcutaneous layer is not part of your epidermis or your dermis. It's called hypodermis or subcutaneous. So there's epidermis, dermis, subcutaneous, or hypodermis, however you want to say it. So epidermis, dermis, hypodermis. Okay? Alright, 90% of epidermal cells, what are they? D. Keratinocytes. Melanocytes is what I like to call a sexy answer. So 80% are melanocytes. And you guys know that this produces the pigment melanin. So melanin is the pigment, melanocytes are the cells that produce the pigment melanin. Intraepidermal macrophages is up there. You guys may know these as Langerhans cells. They come from the red bone marrow. They protect skin against invading microbes deeply damaged by UV radiation. And then Merkel cells, those are tactile cells. You're going to find those in the deepest layer of your epidermis. They contact nerve cells and they're associated with touch sensation. So you have in your epidermis, on the outer layer of your skin, these Merkel cells that, you know, help bring sensation to the nerve cells that are deep inside your epidermis. Okay? Alright, so the dermis, we have five different layers. Which one is only present in thick skin? I know you guys know. Layers. D. Stratum of Stenum. Definitely know that Stratum of Stenum. Mercy College put the heart on for Stratum of Stenum. You know, which one is only present in thick skin? I don't know why, but you're going to find that palms of the hands and the soles of your feet. That's where our thick skin is. Alright, so from starting from the deepest layer, what is the correct order of epidermal strata? You guys need to know that if we're starting from deepest to superficial, what's the deepest layer?
See.
Vestale. Yeah, Vestale is the deepest. The answer here is definitely going to be C. There are some mnemonics that we use to help us remember. Mine is baby spits up, grandpa loses the pool, or come let's get sunburned, that's from superficial to deep. So Vestale, spinosum, granulosum, lucidum, and corneum. Or if it's from superficial to deep, corneum, lucidum, granulosum, spinosum, and then Vestale. You guys need to know the order of the deepest. Know the order in general. Doesn't matter if you know it from deepest to most superficial or superficial. Alright. Your dermis is essential for the survival of the epidermis, and these adjacent layers form many important structural and functional relations. The two layers that make up the dermis include. So remember, when we look at the dermis itself, you have an epidermis and then the dermis. So the epidermis, that would be your skin, that's superficial, that we can swap off. And then underneath that, that's the dermis. So the area between your epidermis and your hypodermis is called the dermis. What's the answer for this one? two layers that make up the dirt. But your papillary region that makes up about a fifth of the thickness of your total dermis. So then blank are small nipple-shaped structures that project into the undersurface of the epidermis. What are these nipple-shaped structures called?
Thank you. everywhere. Eccrine. So eccrine sweat glands, you're going to find them everywhere except in the margins of your lips, your nail beds, fingers and toes, the glans penis and glans clitoris, labia majora, and your eardrum. They are primarily responsible for thermoregulation via thermoregulatory sweating. And then both of these glands, they have the coiled tubes, but African glands, they have larger ducts and lumens. You're going to find those in your armpit, your groin, the areola of your nipples, and bearded regions of the face of adult man. African glands are the ones that make you stinky. African glands are the ones that everyone has everywhere. African glands might make you smell like pennies. Like, they ever had a kid, like, running around in the summertime and smell like pennies? Anyway, modified sweat glands in the external air, ear. You guys need to know all of these glands, the sudoriferous glands, African glands, sebum glands, or sternum glands. Which one are they?
See?
It's a combination of secretions from cerumen and sebaceous glands that make that yellowish material called cerumen. What is cerumen? It's probably known as. You're wet. Fantastic. Excellent. Alright, so here was the hard question, Amelia's question. So one of skin's six functions is vitamin D synthesis. Synthesis requires activation of precursor molecules in the skin by UV rays and sunlight. The enzymes in the liver and kidneys then modify the activated molecule and produces like the most active form of vitamin D. What was our answer?
C.
D. Calcitriol. We don't want to go with calcium. Calcium is what I would call a sexy answer. At the beginning of the semester, we talked a little bit about calcitonin, and then you get introduced to the idea of calcitriol. So calcitriol is a hormone that aids in the absorption of calcium from food to the GI tract. In order to complete this process, a small amount of UV light exposure is required. And you tend to continue to be questioned. New Yorkers, we have issues with vitamin D deficiency. Anybody ever go to the doctor and get your blood work done and they tell you have vitamin D deficiency? You have to take a vitamin D pill? It's happened to me. It's happened to everyone. It actually affects your mood, it affects your performance in a lot of things. It also enhances phagocytic activity, helps you reduce inflammation and regulate immune function. So if you have an autoimmune issue or you have a lot of inflammation, But calcitriol, the whole reason we have calcitriol, it's actually the switch that tells your body to anyway, calcitriol versus calcitonin. These guys remember the thing you calcitonin never helped. Alright, epidermal wounds are considered superficial. Common types include abrasions and minor sunburns. Basal cells are going to migrate across the surface to form a sheet. When the epidermal cells encounter one another, they stop migrating due to a cellular response. Start to heal before it scabs over, a sheet forms. Basal cells are going to migrate across the sheet. And when they get to each other, how do they know to stop making the sheet? We've already closed the wound. How do they know what's the signal?
See?
Yeah, the signal's called contact inhibition. There is a gene that you can have where contact inhibition doesn't happen correctly. If anybody's ever had a keyword scar, or most of us don't get keyword scarring, that signal for contact inhibition doesn't work. So what happens is the basal cells just keep migrating over and over and over and over on top of each other. They get this big, bubbled up, bad looking scar. Sometimes you end up having a crazy anyway. Deep wounds occur when they extend into the dermis, which is superficial wounds. Alright, basal and squamous cell carcinomas are collectively known as. Most of you guys got this wrong. Melanoma skin cancer is not correct because we're not talking about melanocytes. So we're talking about basal and squamous cells. It's going to be non-melanoma skin cancer. So melanoma skin cancers arise from melanocytes. A collection of sebaceous material and dead cells in a hair follicle or sebaceous gland. Without this tomato, anybody know what tomato is commonly known as? Women hate getting these. Guys usually get it on their nose. And then a low price for this is also known as the port wine stain. I used to find it had a big port wine stain all over the front of the face. And she got surgery to get it fixed. And once she got the surgery, the stain was gone.
Oh, yeah. And yeah, I mean, what's this? Yeah. How did you make it?
My gaming chair's over here. I sit over there.
Oh, okay, you have two chairs.
Yeah, I have two chairs.
I like it. Yes,
this is actually not comfortable. I used to have two gaming chairs at the other room. And now I don't know if it's going out there to put an exercise bike, so I brought my little love here.
Well, if you want to give me a gaming chair, my chair will be good. I will let you take touch of your hands. I will go to your house.
Want this sofa?
Yes. If you're willing to take it with all my chairs, literally. Oh, it's so wobbly. It's so bad. It's really bad. I mean, having to, like, grab it to myself on it, but it doesn't work. I'm so serious, bro. I also have to just deal with the library, but I'm like, how am I going to get in the building?
Nobody would ask
me. If they would, if the school would leave me alone, leave me alone. You shared it with me?
Oh, I'm gonna send it to you.
Thank you. Cops knocking on my door. Well, this shit not fucking searching. The fuck?